Hi guys, welcome to my channel. This is Dr. Beth with Area 51 Farms. In this particular vlog, I'm going to share with you an unusual collection I have. All right guys, stay tuned. I have an unusual flute collection, and no, I do not play the flute. I play other instruments, but I don't really play these, but I play around with them. So I'm going to play a few for you and tell you a little about it. First of all, I got these two flutes from called High Spirit Flutes, and it's on the internet. They have a website. These are handmade, and they're impressive, and you're going to pay at least $100 for the first baseline average beginner flute. The first one I've ever gotten was in the key of A, and this one is pretty easy to play. It is a six-hole flute, and there's no decoration on it or anything. It's the first one I got, and it'll come with actually the third hole covered, and I removed that to turn it into a six-hole flute, but I could play it around. I carried this in my backpack out in the backfields. Now, this flute is in the same key, but as you notice, it's made out of actually a soft cedar-type wood, and it's inlaid with turquoise, and it's much more, this is beautiful. This one, when I'm in a different mood, I will play this one. To me, it sounds a little bit warmer and richer. Maybe not. But this one is a lot of fun. Obviously, it's much more expensive in price. Now, oddly enough, I won this one on the internet. There was another vlogger from Ireland, and he had a contest for people, and I won this one. I don't even know that I can play it because he's a professional flute player. It's made out of a hard plastic, and it's actually tunable, which makes it interesting because I would think a professional flutist, flautist, professionals are going to want to tune, and he really was tired of this one. It's one he'd had for a really long time. I won it. He mailed it to me from Ireland. Really cool. I don't play it much because to me it's a little more challenging, and it's a different mouthpiece. It's actually a shaped mouthpiece, and it's more like a whistle. Sounds like a whistle. I bought this in a museum in Bentonville, Arkansas. And this one, I'm not even sure what key it is in, but this one was handmade as well, and it's an inblown flute. And it sounds differently, but sometimes it's just more, it's fun to play. It's got these decorative little leather straps on it. I want you to see the end of it. So much different than compared to the ones that I were playing. See the ends? Whoa, yeah. This one is inblown. And you just put your lips on it and gently blow. Like that. This one, you're going to form more of a shape around the mouthpiece. If you want to be a beginner, you can get these plastic ones that are in the stores. And they're made for basically beginners. And these are five-hole flutes and more for children. Once again, it's got the inblown mouthpiece. I felt the need to buy this one. It's got more of a whistle end on it like the other one did. Shaped whistle, I call them. There's probably a more professional sound for that. This is a lower pitched, but the fingerings are really far apart, and it was more just to add to my collection. I really can't play it, guys, and I'm not sure why I got it, but it was a little pricey. I guess I'm going to have to practice and watch a bunch of YouTube to learn how to play it. This is a kenna. This is made out of bamboo, and it's from South America. It's played a lot by the Peruvian people. It has a very unique embouchure one of which I cannot play for you today. I think I've made some sounds out of it the other day, and I'll practice on this thing and I'll watch some YouTubes, but let me show you this little divot here. Very unique embouchure, but then again, this is not considered a Native American instrument. This is considered something from more Peru and those areas. The kina. This one's called the drone. They're double, considered doubled flutes. So one side is just a basically, there's no holes on this one. This one is a standard flute, so you can play one side of it without playing the other. And I haven't really played this one a very long time. I think I have it more for decoration. My husband bought it as a gift, but I'm not one to really play it very much because it requires much more expertise than what I can play, and I don't practice it, so. So you've got that kind of double pit flute sound going on. This one was a gift. Honestly, I'm surprised they didn't put the key on it. I'd have to get it with my keyboard and try to measure it up to see what the key really is of this instrument. It is more of a bass flute, and I need to do some maintenance on it, so I'm not even sure I'll be able to get a sound of it out of it because there's one of these have loosened up on the top, and so there's not a good covering. I can't even get a sound out of it right now. It's out of my length and my ability to reach on the instrument. I think I just got it mainly for looks. Although it has a very beautiful, deep, rich sound, I'm going to have to do some work on it, but see if you can see. The nice thing about these flutes is there's always some decorative pieces on the top, and they'll put some beautiful etching on the wood there. All the way down. These are traditional six-hole flutes, but I really don't know the key of this one. And I got this one in Eureka Springs, Arkansas. And actually, I told you, and it has this, not wearing my glasses, the year this one was handmade was 2002, and it's in the key of C. This flute that was from Bentonville that's played on the end here, inblown, is not got a key on it, but it was made in 2012 and somewhere in that area. It's kind of a heavy, very heavy instrument. It's called a dirigidoo. Dirigidoo, if I'm saying that right. And this is an Aborigine played type instrument. They're really good at it. But it takes quite a bit of technique to blow on them. And if you want to see some YouTube people, you can. It really does make my lips itch when I play it. You have to do some major buzzing with it. But it's really a great instrument to learn how to play. That's the best you're going to get because it makes my lips itch. My collection, the rest of them are Irish whistles, and I'm trying to learn how to play some of them, and I'll maybe work up some tunes and play them. Oh yeah, here's one more instrument that is not really in. Well, yeah, I guess it is. You know what? I would argue that this one goes back to biblical times. It's a ram's horn, and you buzz it just like you do the dirigidoo. It's a ram's horn. And now that my lips are all numb and ready to, I don't have the larger one, but I'd love to get a big, long ram's horn like they talk about in scriptures. Very small. I can't make much of a sound out of it, but maybe someday somebody will get me a real nice one from Israel that I can play, because this plays a lot like a trumpet. You buzz your lips, but this mouth hole on here and that to play into that horn, that ram's horn, is so tiny, and my lips are kind of swollen from playing the dirigidoo. Well, that's my collection there of my Native American instruments and my two other odd instruments, the kina and the dirigidoo, which are their own parts of the world. I hope you enjoyed it. That's just some one of my odd collections that I have, and I enjoy playing them around the farm. That makes me really calm, happy, and peaceful, and I think my animals love it. So maybe sometime I'll go out and play for them and you can watch how they react to hearing music. It's calming and it's healing.